probably so excited, though you're trying to hide it. Here's a horn and it sounds like a bull. We are the show's ensemble and we know our moms will be so proud that we're a part of this musical. You'll be blown away, so put your phone away, unless that's how you're watching right now. You're about to see our play on WCA. You're about to see it right after we start up the stream, but first some more of the scene, because we've got some disclaimers to bring. This is an unlicensed spoof, we're all just trying to goof here. I mean, really, Peter Solo says everything to avoid arraignment. This is just entertainment, any trademarking we disavow. It's all totally free, our play on WCA, you're about to see it right.
After this message about our platform.
Open broadcast software.
We're using it to show you these lovely digital
curtains you're scoping, which we promise to open, because that's just what you're hoping we'll do. As we keep singing this song, we know it's taking so long.
Yeah, we'll start it now.
Oh, my phone is cracked.
Good morning, Major Monogram.
Morning, Carl. Did you get the mission briefing ready for Agent P?
Yes, sir.
Did you pick up my laundry?
Washed, steamed, and pressed.
And the bananas for Agent M? If you don't give him exactly 32, he's gonna start throwing his great googly moogly! Is that camera on?
Well, yes, sir. Don't you remember?
Who are all of these non-agents tuning in? What is this, some kind of audience?
Sir, did you have to go and break the fourth wall this early into the show?
Oh, well, I'm sorry, Carl. I guess I'm just not used to this many humans watching me at once. Not since my days at the Academy.
Sir, I think they're expecting some entertainment.
Well, what are you gonna do? Some tap dancing?
I'm not scheduled for that until well into the second act. Why don't we start with a brief introduction?
Okay, I suppose it's not much different than a typical mission briefing. Hello, everyone. This is Major Monogram, and here with me is Carl, the intern. It seems that you've somehow found us inside the headquarters of the OWCA.
Oh, that's Organization Without a Cool Acronym.
Quiet, Carl. We're not paying you to interrupt me.
You're not paying me at all, sir.
Anyway, we're getting a report that two boys by the names of Phineas Flynn and Ferb Fletcher are putting on a full-fledged musical. And this time, it's virtual. It's your job to get out there, find out what they're up to, and put a stop
to it. Don't put a stop to it. They're not doing anything evil. They're just—
Hang it, Carl. What are we not paying you for? Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, Musical Without a Cool Acronym.
There's 104 days of summer vacation, so school comes along just to end it. So the annual problem for our generation is finding a good way to spend it.
Hi, everyone. Wait, hold on a second. That's better.
Building a rocket or fighting a mummy or climbing up the Eiffel Tower, discovering something that doesn't exist,
hey!
Or giving a monkey a shower,
serving tidal waves, creating nanobots,
or locating Frankenstein's brain.
It's over here!
Finding a dodo bird, painting a continent,
or driving our sister insane.
Phineas!
Oh, this could possibly be the best day ever.
This could possibly be the best day ever.
And the forecast says that tomorrow will likely be a million and six times better. So make every minute count, jump up, jump in, and seize the day. And let's make sure that in
every single possible way,
today is gonna be a great day. Crossing the tundra or building a roller coaster, skiing down a mountain of beans, devising a system for remembering everything, or synchronizing submarines,
racing chariots, taming tiger sharks,
constructing a portal to Mars,
been there,
building a time machine, stretching a rubber tree,
wailing away on guitars.
Oh man,
this could possibly be the best. best day ever.
This could possibly be the best
and
day ever.
The forecast says that tomorrow will likely be a million
six times better.
So make every minute count, jump up, jump in, and seize the day. And let's make sure that in every single possible way, today's gonna be a great day.
Hey.
Put our heads together and design a master plan.
We may miss dinner, but I know Mom will understand.
We've got our mission and suppliers, yogurt, gumballs, and desire.
And a pocket full of rubber bands.
The menu on handstands.
A unicycle compass and a camera that won't focus.
And a canteen full of soda.
Grab a beach towel, here we go.
It's fantastic!
This could possibly be the best day ever.
This could possibly be the best
day. And the forecast says that tomorrow will likely be a million and six times better. So make every minute count, jump up, jump in, and seize the day. And let's make sure that in every single possible way.
As you can see, there's a whole lot of stuff to do before school starts this fall.
Come on, Harry!
So stick with us, cause Phineas and Ferb are gonna do it all. So stick with us, cause Phineas and Ferb are gonna do it all.
Mom! Phineas and Ferb are putting on an unlicensed virtual parody musical!
Great opening, everybody! Ferb and I will take it from here.
Bye, Phineas.
See you tomorrow.
So
see you later, guys.
We talked about eight.
Summer. You know, Ferb, they make us go to school for 7 hours a day, 5 days a week, 180 days a year, and then give us a measly 3 months of freedom during the hottest season of the year. What are we supposed to do during our break? Yeah. We've done some cool stuff already. From beach parties to roller coasters to becoming one-hit wonders, these 104 days have been flying by. Sort of like that miniature golf course we made when it propelled itself across town. I guess I'm just not ready for this all to end. Spending the summer with you has been a blast, bro. I'm sure gonna miss it when it's over.
Are you nerds getting sentimental with each other?
Hey, Buford.
I don't know what it is you've got planned for today, but it better not be gooey.
Well, we haven't settled on anything yet.
Phineas, I for one admire the relationship between you and your brother. It is a wholesome camaraderie that encourages me to come over here and take a break from studying.
It's summer, you dweeb.
It is never too early to start getting ahead.
It's never too early to get a fist to the head either.
Well, Belgique is right, Buford. Planning ahead is the key to success. Ferb and I have already drawn up blueprints for projects we may not even build until later this morning.
I don't care what color your prints are. You're not going to convince me to do any work during summer. But, what were you planning?
Ferb? Theme park for ants. I think we can go a little bigger than that. Fight off anthropomorphic pistachio monsters? Sounds like that'd work better in the future. Create a multi-billion-dollar app primarily used for song remixes and iterated dance videos? Where'd you get that idea, Ferb?
Hello, boys. Your mother and I are headed to my appointment for LASIK surgery.
You're going to let people put lasers in your eyes?
I sure am, Baljeet. These glasses have served me well. But it's time to embrace what modern technology can do for us. And, oh dear, I forgot my Walkman. I've got to scurry.
Good luck, Dad!
Oh, thank you, boys. Be good today. Your sister is home if you need anything.
Man, lasers are so cool. That's it! Ferb, I know what we're gonna do today.
Giant death laser?
Well, almost. I was thinking a giant laser tag arena. See, that's new territory for us.
Yeah, all right.
We're gonna need some fiber lenses and a jar of peanut butter.
Yeah.
so bored. So not wanting to get out of bed.
Candace, I'm going to take Lawrence to the ophthalmologist. Why don't you do something fun for yourself today? Maybe go outside?
Too hot.
You could go to the mall.
Too far.
Maybe pick up a book to read.
Whoa, Mom, let's not get crazy. I'll call Stacy.
All right, call me if you need anything. And I mean need. You don't have to update me on what the boys are doing every couple of minutes.
Yeah, what are the boys doing?
Goodbye, Candace.
Hey, girl.
Stacy, I think I know what I'm gonna do today. Mom and Dad are leaving, and we both know Phineas and Ferb are gonna do something big, bombastic, and bustable.
Oh yeah, like that golf course.
Yes, but this time, Mom's gonna see it before it's gone. I'll make sure of it. The boys can't keep getting away with their shenanigans for the whole summer.
Well, what are they doing today?
Not sure. They've got a bunch of tools, a power loader, glow-in-the-dark paint, and... is that a cannon? Stace, they've got a cannon.
Cool.
Oh, they are so busted. When Mom sees this, she's gonna flip. It's dangerous and noticeable and...
and it glows in the dark.
And it glows in the dark. There's nothing that's gonna stop me from bringing those two
Was that a cannon?
No, Jeremy.
Jeremy?
Jeremy! Ah! I'll talk to you later, Stacy.
Good luck.
Thanks. Hi, Jeremy.
Hey, Candace. So I know this is kind of last minute, but there's this dance. It's at the Danville Community Center tonight, and I was wondering if you wanted to go with me. It's nothing too formal.
Go with you as, like, friends, or walk you there to make sure you don't get hurt on the way, or as a chaperone, or a butler, or...
No, I mean, go with me as a date.
A date? Me? Go? On a date? With you? To a dance? As a date? With you?
Yeah. It'll be fun.
Will you excuse me for a second?
Mm-hmm.
Ah! Whoa, careful with the cannon, Buford!
What time?
Well, the dance starts at 7, but could I pick you up at 6:30?
Oh, 6:30. Bus brothers. Yeah, I think I could squeeze that in.
All right, cool. I'll see you then.
Okay, bye. A date with Jeremy. I gotta go get dressed.
Perfect guy, I'm like gonna cry. I got tears coming out of my nose. Hot dang, he's a hunky man, and he plays in a band, and he wears those cute fleshy dog clothes. One day he will propose.
Yes, Candace, I just heard the news. I'm so happy for you. You two are basically meant to be.
Hey, Candace, man, way to go. Now just go with the flow, but let me know and I can be there to see.
When he gets down on one.
It's across the street where you and Phineas can meet, cause you think he's really a catch.
Look, can we just dispatch?
Oh my god, you guys. Isabella has butterflies.
Yes.
Every single time she looks at him, she gets those googly eyes. Oh my god, you guys.
I did not.
You and Phineas were meant to be.
I don't think he even notices me.
They're just like the couple from
girls bestow. True, 4, 6, 2, 3, 1. Getting our patches so. Is he his?
it's a home run.
What?
Find him in his backyard, ask him what he's doing, and so he shows regard. Offer up with his flea.
That's not
creepy, but once a day, your drill is understood. As long as nothing frays our sacred bond of sisterhood. Oh my god, oh my god, you got...
Hey, Isabella, where'd you go?
Pinky, where's Isabella?
She's tired of us teasing her?
She's going across the street?
She's going to get a hideous tattooing? Oh, she's going to see what Phineas is doing.
Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god!
It's almost there. This dress needs to be refined, make him lose his mind, but it can't outright say I'm aflame. It's gotta look somewhat casual, not like I overthought it. I can't have him thinking I'm lame, or our kids will be ashamed. Oh my god, you guys, the best day of my life is about to arise. For these past 4 minutes, just wanted to soliloquize. Oh my god, you guys!
Ah!
Help me dress for my fairy tale. Not too gothic and not too pale.
Girl next door meets puppy, mom meets goddess, who's been glamorized.
Oh my god, you guys! Excuse me. Phineas! Ferb!
Hi, Candace.
I don't have time for one of your ridiculous inventions today. I've got a date to prepare for.
Okay, have fun, sis.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means have fun on your date tonight.
Don't think that I don't think that I know what you two are thinking.
Oh my god, you guys.
You can build your obnoxious whatever, but mom's gonna see it when she gets home.
Here we go for the millionth time.
I'm not about to let my big day get in the way of bringing you two down. I may be in love, but I'm not stupid. You're glued to my eyes.
Oh my god, Candace, honey, remember your day. All this busting can wait.
And it's not like they have any harm planned.
Hey, Phineas, what you doing now? Something that's gonna wow.
Yeah, we're making a laser tag land. And we sure would love a hand. Targeting on the targeting system? Right now we just have Buford on that.
Boom! It works!
It does!
Yeah. Wait, where's Perry?
Huh. Well, they couldn't have gone far. He's just a platypus. They don't do much.
Semi-aquatic gag lion, mammal of action.
Dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-dooby-d
Did I unmute myself, Carl?
Yes, you did it this time, sir. Good job. Good.
Make sure you get my good side.
Yeah, I know. It's the right side, right, sir?
It's the front. Good morning, Agent P. As always, the evil Dr. Doofenshmirtz is up to his old tricks again. We've received top secret intel suggesting that Doof has been building a poolinator. This alleged machine...
Sir, it's not top secret. He posted about it on his blog.
Please, Carl, I'm trying to keep this professional. Wait, is this the same blog as the one with the top 10 celebrity face swaps?
Yes, sir.
Oh, hold on, Agent P, you gotta see this. Look, it's the Rock's head on the Queen's body! Oh!
Did you see number 8, sir?
Number 8, which one is that?
Danny DeVito and the Groundhog from Groundhog Day.
Oh, yes. Carl, sign me up for updates from this website.
You already are, sir. It's how we found out about the Poolinator.
That's right, the Poolinator. Doofenshmirtz has allegedly built a machine capable of creating swimming pools in the backyards of Danville citizens. We're not exactly sure how he intends to use this machine for evil, but it's your mission to get out there, find out what he's up to, and put a stop to it. Good luck, Agent P. Monogram out. Okay, he's gone. Carl, put the playlist of sitcom episodes without laugh tracks back up on the screen.
You got it, sir. They truly are haunting.
Doofenshmirtz Evil Incorporated!
How does a misfit, misanthrope son of a Viking in Gimmelstup, dropped without a thought and brought up by ocelots in the Drusostinian woods where the knights were also chillin', grow up to be a budding evil villain? For $10, I found an offer on a website and I proctored it. After getting mocked a bit, I bought my own doctorate. A golden land of dreams is where I knew that I should head. But I wound up in America instead. Got married, had a daughter, and I turned my life around, man, while my brother was elected mayor of this town, man. Now I'm divorced, while of course he gets the fame, and nobody knows my name.
What is your name, sir?
Dr. Heinz Doofenshmirtz. My name is Dr. Heinz Doofenshmirtz, and I'm someone whom success averts, but just you wait, just you wait!
I'm waiting, sir.
No, that was the end of the song! I was being rhetorical, Norm! Why don't you go find the remote to my self-destruct button?
Okay.
What are you doing? Why are you just standing there?
I thought you were being rhetorical.
We'll work on this. Hey! My wall! It's broken!
That's the fourth wall this week.
Who just burst? Is that a platypus? The platypus! Your surprise entrance is immaculate! And by immaculate, I mean completely immaculate! You're trapped now, Barry the platypus! I was anticipating your arrival!
He has spent the whole morning talking about you.
Your hat! Yes, your ridiculous little hat! That was the exclusive topic! I mean, what is that? A wide brim? The 1940s called Perry the Platypus! They want their hat back!
I didn't see anyone call, sir.
That was... that was a joke, Norm!
Ha! Ha! Ha!
Yeah, forget about it. Anyway... I have to say, you really did a number on my wall over there. I hope you intend to pay for that! Well, if you're not just destroying my building for fun now, you must be here because Major Monobrow made you aware of the caliber of disaster indicated by the presence of my Poolinator in our tri-state area.
One moment.
Well, you got Evil Berry Platypus right here. I say evil in downtown Denver. Why, sure, I'm a doctor. Got my doctorate off of Craigslist. I'm mighty proud to say it. I consider that the hours that I spend with lab tools in my hand are golden. Help me cultivate a sharp brain and a slight slouch, but a keen eye. Did you ever go and try to make clones of yourself by combining a tanning bed with a photocopier? But just as I say, it takes judgment, brains, and maturity to be an evil scientist. I say that any doof can try to rule the world without a tragic past, and I say that's vain. The first big step on the road to the domination of mankind, yes, I say first, emotional neglect from your parents, then giant walking robots. And the next thing you know, you're battling aggressive animal agents in hats and presenting them with your evil plans and backstories, telling them about your savage youth. Not savage parental abuse, no, but actually being raised by wild ocelot. And this is after your disowning father made you be a law gnome, make your butt boil, well, I should say. Now, Perry the Platypus, let me tell you my scheme. You got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 lasers of destruction. Lasers that can carve giant pits of dirt in each and every person's backyard with a capital B, and that rhymes with B, and that stands for pool. Enator. Now, all summer long, the tri-state youth have been frittering away. I say the tri-state youth have been frittering. Frittering away. And looking for a way they can cool off with leisure. I'll shoot lasers at their yard. Don't mind if it kills their dandelions. They'll see a huge ditch and think, now we're talking. They'll start pumping water to make a swimming pool, but they'll need chlorine and they'll need it from me, and that's evil. Yeah, this part's really, really evil. I bought all the chlorine in the city, so if they want to swim cleanly, they gotta pay me. Make me stinking rich, cause I'm evil. Yes, I'll be the shark of the city. Evil with a capital E, and that rhymes with B, and that stands for pool. Enator. Now, I know you may not be seeing the big picture here, so I'm gonna be perfectly clear. Would you like to know what I'm gonna spend my money on when I make my monopolistic fortune? I won't buy a mansion. I won't buy sports cars. I won't buy new innators or self-destruct buttons. I won't brag about how rich I am or the flawlessness of my ingenious plan. But what's better, I'll go to City Hall, sign up to run for mayor. My hard-earned cash will get me campaigning. It's Heinz time. I'll shamelessly run against my brother, favorite of my mother, and beat him to the curb, then cause in an instant masteria. Friends, wads of cash are evil's plaything, evil! In the tri-state area.
In the tri-state area.
With a capital E, and that rhymes with P, and that stands for pool.
That stands for pool.
We surely got even.
We surely got even.
Right here in the city.
Right here.
Just gotta figure out a way to keep Norm busy while I rule.
I'm helping my dad be
evil. Now.
Evil.
The Platypus. In case you still doubt me, let me give you an idea of my corruption. The minute I was born in Gimmelstup, neither one of my parents showed up. My biological father never respected me. I was merely a lawn gnome that he had to feed. I wasn't allowed to move. I had to make friends with a balloon. My past was such a wreck, certain words haunt me to this day. Words like only son. And baking soda volcano. I've got a lot to avenge. You got evil in the tri-state area. With a capital E, and that rhymes with P, and that stands for pool.
Oh,
surely I'm evil.
Oh, surely he's evil.
I'm a ne'er-do-well ruffian. Get ready for Dr. Heinz Doofenshmirtz to rule.
All citizens will bow to evil.
Oh, we got evil. We got terrible, terrible evil. My complex scheme is what they call proof of fuel.
Proof of fuel.
Oh, yes, we got evil, evil, evil.
Oh, yes, we got evil. Here we got evil.
With a capital E.
With a capital E.
That rhymes with P.
That rhymes with P.
And that stands for pool.
That stands for pool.
That was great, gals. Take five.
Thank you, five.
These shoes.
So you see, Perry the Platypus, my work will be cut out for me. Literally. All I have to do is aim my pollinator at a bunch of citizens' backyards, shoot some lasers, wait for people to inevitably install swimming pools, charge them inflated prices for chlorine, make copious amounts of money, run for mayor, show up my brother, and begin my evil regime of the tri-state area! It will be unprecedented!
Because I won't be president, I'll be mayor. You've got to start out realistically. I'm a realist. Now, I know what you're thinking. Isn't this like your third evil scheme that involves swimming pools? Well, this is only my second evil scheme that involves creating a scarcity of a natural resource. And trust me, chlorine is way more sought after than zinc. I mean, zinc foil, it never really got on the way I was hoping. I guess when you already have tin foil and aluminium...
Dad, can you borrow the car tonight?
Well, I'm going to a dance.
Oh! Yeah, you can borrow the car, sweetie, but, could you fill up with gas while you're out?
You know, you'd be able to afford a full tank of gas if you didn't spend all your alimony checks on these chorus girls.
Well, excuse me, princess! They helped me explain my schemes! Tell her, Perry the Platypus! You have a much clearer idea of how evil I am when I have dancers, right?
Hey, Perry. Well, thanks for the keys, but I'm pretty sure one of those dancers just went into my room, so I'm gonna go take care of that.
You'll learn. When you try to explain an evil scheme without chorus girls and nobody understands your motivation, you'll say, "Oh, you were right." And don't drive too fast! Ugh, teenagers, what are you gonna do?
Sir, I don't need to borrow a car or use gas to fuel my engine.
Can it, junk pile? Go find my remote! Okay, Perry the Platypus. I just have to get a few more things ready. So just stay put. Oh, that's right. You don't have a choice because you're trapped! Ah!
Good one, sir. Ha, 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 ha.
Oh, now you recognize a joke. And turn your video feed off, Perry the Platypus. I'm trying to save bandwidth.
Yeah, Johnny, I'm good for tonight. Were you just gonna wear... I mean, I'm not wearing anything fancy. It's stupid anyway. We're just going to be ironic, right? Ugh, hold on. My mom's calling. Hey, Mom.
Vanessa, I'm just calling to make sure you have your plans worked out for this weekend.
Yeah.
Did you find a ride? The dance is tonight, right?
Yeah, it's tonight. Dad gave me his keys.
Aw, how nice. What's he up to?
I don't know, something evil?
Vanessa Doofenshmirtz, your father is not evil. We just didn't get along. We wanted different things.
Was one of those things to be evil? Because he's evil.
He's not evil, honey. No one's evil.
Mom, I heard him test fire a laser earlier.
Well, he is a scientist.
Right, a scientist with a poolinator and accompanying dance number.
That doesn't sound evil.
No, it's evil. He has evil schemes, and then there's a secret agent that always bursts in.
I just think you're being overly dramatic.
Mom, I'm not being dramatic. I gotta go.
Make sure you drive safely.
Bye. I'm back. My parents are the worst. Anyway, yeah, I'll be there at 7. Cool. Also, did you hear the new Severed Poodle album? It's good, right? Suriya puriya pilibiribuda, suriya puriya pilibiribuda, suriya puriya pilibiribuda, dumdinta paratata. Suriya puriya pilibiribuda, suriya puriya pilibiribuda, suriya puriya pilibiribuda, dumdinta paratata.
Our last shipment is in.
Yes, sir.
7 chromium nickel alloy 99 grade steel H-beams, 14 crates of tricolor LED lights, 24 fiber brack grating, surround sound audio system with 16 loudspeakers, and 2 10-watt subwoofers, 1 30-foot titanium sculpture of a dragon, and a jar of peanut butter. Sign here, please.
Thank you.
Say, you look awfully familiar. Do I know you from somewhere?
It's possible. We get a lot of shipments.
Huh. Well, aren't you a little young to be building a recreational coliseum with state-of-the-art laser technology?
Yes. Yes, I am.
Well, it's good to see the younger generation taking initiative. Have fun!
Thanks. I think we're ready, gang.
Why just act our age? The world is ours. Time to engage.
Blast the bass and flash the lights. Welcome to the laser fight.
Run, shoot, play it cool. Please follow the safety rules.
Blast away your friends on sight. Welcome to the laser fight.
This bridge has a robot boss. 15 points if you can cross.
Score 100 points to win, then double elimination.
Our vests are on.
It's time for big fun.
Big fun.
Our guns are drawn.
Let's have some big fun.
Big fun.
With lit technology, we'll be a laser prodigy.
It's big fun.
Big fun. Big fun.
Okay, okay, okay. So the hoop earrings go with the red dress.
No, hoops go with blue.
You want the dangly topaz.
Wait. Do you guys hear that? It sounds like danger and insolence.
I think it's your brothers.
Jenny, window report!
Whoa, some kid shot a beam of green while bouncing on a trampoline.
Bouncing up and taking flight. Welcome to the laser fight.
Big, bad, treacherous. Just wait till Mom gets a load of this.
Crush the giant parasite. Welcome to the laser fight.
Dreams are coming true, but how can I let this ensue? I won't delay, I won't digress. My mom is gonna see this mess.
Our vests are on.
It's time for big fun.
Big fun.
Our guns are drawn.
Let's have some big fun.
Big fun.
What are you doing, Stace?
I think I just destroyed Blue's base.
Ugh.
Big fun, big fun, big fun.
Actually looks like
big fun, big fun, big fun.
All right, blue nerds, listen up. In 19 seconds, Red's wall goes down. When that happens, what are we gonna do?
Gonna make him go.
Big fun, big fun.
Blue team approaching 12:30.
Big fun, big fun.
Let it be, Fred, get off of me.
Big fun, big fun.
Mom, emergency. You've got to come home right this second.
Did a satellite crash into the house?
Where are you, Ferb?
I'm coming for you!
Candace, are your brothers okay?
No, they're shooting lasers at each other!
Lasers, really? Candace, I think you need to cool off.
This round is hot, hot, hot. It's time for big fun,
big fun.
Molten lava on spot.
We're having big fun,
big fun.
So let the speakers blow while we escape this volcano.
Mom, you have no clue about all the things your children do.
Time is running out, so help me make a turnabout.
It's big fun,
big fun,
big fun,
big fun,
big fun, big fun.
And the winner is Red Team.
Yeah!
Mom, did you hear me? I'm serious. Phineas and Ferb built a 100-foot coliseum in the backyard, and now they're shooting laser guns at each other.
Oh, did little duffers donate their old laser tag equipment?
No, Mom, these are real lasers, like the Star Warsy blaster kind.
Uh-huh, just like that Star Warsy rocket ship they flew to space last month?
Yes, well, sort of. I mean, this one's still on Earth. If you just come home...
I'm sorry, Candace, but Lawrence is still getting LASIK, the non-Star Warsy doctor kind. I can't leave until he's done.
Oh, Candace, you gotta join us next time. These things are the coolest.
Actually, Mom, stay right there. Hey, can I see that a second?
You're on the red team. Tag name, Hirano Hellraiser.
Hey, radical name.
Hey, thanks. That's what my parents used to call me.
I got this plugged into the power strip correctly? Behold, Perry the Platypus, as I begin my domination of the dry state suburban aquatic leisure landscaping industry. Ah! And now we wait.
Honey, why is there a swimming pool-sized pit of dirt in our backyard?
There's one in mine, too.
Same here.
Dink Winkerson here. This just in, we have received reports that 6-foot-deep pits of dirt have materialized in the lawns of several suburban residences here in Danville. We aren't sure how this has happened or who is responsible, but stay tuned as we attempt to fill in the large gaping holes in the story about... large gaping holes. Can you please tell us what you saw?
Well, there I was, sitting in my backyard, frittering away in the summer heat. I say frittering, when all of a sudden there's this flash, a green beam of light. Then suddenly 100 square feet of my backyard is 6 feet underground. Now all I can do is fritter away, but 6 feet lower.
And you, what are you going to do with your damaged property?
I'm going to turn it into a luxurious swimming pool by innocently filling it with water from my hose. Hey, that's a good idea.
Hey, yeah. Let's do what the robot said.
Now we don't have to fritter anymore.
And I like how he said innocently.
Honey, don't flush the toilet. I need to use 20,000 gallons of water.
Truly remarkable. As one turns lemons into lemonade, these citizens have decided to turn their damaged property into slightly more valuable, flooded damaged property. That leaves us with just one question. Where will one purchase the chlorine to clean and maintain these swimming pools?
The only place stocked with a supply of chlorine is Doofenshmirtz Evil Incorporated, located in downtown Danville.
And what building would that be?
The one that says Evil on it. Well, let's go buy some before it sells out.
Yeah!
Hooray for disposable income!
And there you have it, a community coming together in light of catastrophe to purchase chlorine. And this just in, my husband says he wants me to pick up some before they sell out. This reporter is out. Peace.
This is taking a bit longer than I thought it would. Usually my schemes are much more instantaneous than this. But you know what they say, sink or swim. And I didn't have any sinks to sell, so I have to be patient with the swimming pool thing. Could I get you some tea or coffee? One lump or two? Okay, sheesh!
You gotta take a look at this!
Candace, did you ride your bike all the way here?
I ran, but that's not important. Look at this thing Phineas and Ferb built!
Well, that certainly looks like it's out of a Star Wars movie. It's nice to see the boys getting into arts and crafts.
No, Mom, this thing works, and it's just a part of their whole laser death tournament amalgamation.
All right, boys and girls, it's time for the bonus round!
You have 60 seconds to make your way through the dungeon! Whichever team gets further gets a health bonus for the final exhibition.
And there's one twist. In the dungeon, your blasters are disabled. You'll have to get through it with only your raw dexterity and teamwork. May the best team win.
And the worst team perish!
Yeah. You know, figuratively. Right? Okay, 60 seconds are on the clock.
Watch this, Mom.
That's very creative, dear. But aren't you a little old to be playing with toys in a doctor's office?
What? No, I must not be doing this thing right. It was working a second ago.
Candace, is that you?
Oh,
Lawrence, how'd it go?
Oh, not so bad. They said I was their star pupil.
Eye puns? Iris, afraid of that.
Oh, they're only going to get cornier from here, darling.
Oh.
I wanna die.
Candace, would you wait here with your stepfather while I sign some paperwork?
Sure. How'd the surgery go, Dad?
Oh, fine. How's your day been?
Well, Jeremy asked me to go to the Danville Community Dance tonight, which is really amazing because it's Jeremy and he wants to go on a date with me, which means he likes me, and that's a really big deal. So I invited Jenny and Stacey to come over help me figure out what I was going to wear, but then Phineas and Ferb with this really big laser tag Coliseum with cannons and lava and Metron and bugs. So I put my life on hold to tell Mom what they were doing, but she didn't believe me, so I ran her with this blaster thing and proof everything, but when I tried to fire it off, it just... Okay, it didn't do that. Please tell me you saw that!
Well, I can't see much of anything right now, but it sounds like they're showing Star Wars in the waiting room.
Oh, you're a fan, huh?
Well, it's all right, but I prefer science fiction films with rock and roll musical numbers.
Papers are signed, we are all good to go.
We are very lucky we have insurance to cover procedures like this.
Some people would give their right arm for the privilege.
Okay, come on, let's get home.
Oh my!
Slow down, Candace, it's not a race. That's odd, was that a hole in the wall there a minute ago?
Okay, I hope you like Earl Grey. It's all I had left after the dancers went through my kitchen. Oh, someone is here. Hello.
Hi, is this where I can buy chlorine for a swimming pool?
It sure is.
Fantastic. I'll take a gallon, please.
That will be $1 million.
I can't afford that.
Okay, for you, 500.
Now that's a deal. Here, take all my money.
Thank you. Now that, Perry the Platypus, is how you do business. I just earned $500 from one sale. Now just... 1,999 more sales for, you know, one sale where they don't ask for a bargain, and I would have $1 million to finance the mayoral campaign! Wait, where did you go? So that's how you're going to play it, huh? Well, you're too late! The laws of capitalism are already in effect! Ha! You missed! Oh. Hey, don't punch the camera. That's not fair.
That platypus is beating up the pharmacist.
Everybody, run!
I'm not a pharmacist, okay? Just because I wear a lab coat. Lots of people wear lab coats for lots of different reasons. Oh, oh, now where are you going? My poolinator, stop! You just put it in the concentrated fire mode! Now it's going to fire all 6 lasers at once! There is not enough voltage!
HMP!
Great! There goes my inator. 2 weeks of rehearsal for that expositional pool song down the drain. Well, at least I made $500.
Woo! Woo! Hi, I'm from the Wall Repair Company. We came to fix that platypus-shaped hole in the wall you called us about earlier. That'll be $500. Wow, 500 in cash. Pharmacists make bank.
Curse you! Bury the platypus!
An
And in a stunning turn of events, the final exhibition round ends with both teams at exactly 99 points.
Wait, what does that mean, Phineas?
It's time for the tiebreaker. Ferb, bring out the giant target. This is what we call rapid fire. Each team will take aim at the target right there, which controls the pinwheel you see up there. Red shots turn the pinwheel clockwise, and blue shots turn it counterclockwise. Fire as many times as you can in the 10-second window, and whichever direction the pinwheel is spinning at the end determines which team will be declared champions. Back over to you, Holly.
You heard the man. Both teams, take aim. On your mark, get set.
That wasn't me!
Ferb, is the pinwheel supposed to be spinning that fast? And have the load-bearing capacity to carry the weight of the entire Colosseum?
I'm the one who's been carrying!
Yeah, we're being lifted into the sky.
Okay, everyone, stay calm and follow the exit signs!
You want us to jump out?
Don't worry, your laser tag vests double as parachute vests!
Nice touch, Isabella.
This kind of thing happens often enough.
You're on a mob!
Oh, yeet!
Whoa!
Every single time.
Right there, Mom! You see it? You see it?
Hi, Mom!
Hey, boys. All right, Candace, I give up. What am I supposed to be looking at?
What? No, it was all just right there! The stereo, the lasers, the robot boss!
Why do I feel like we've had this conversation before?
Linda, darling?
Oh, I've gotta go help Lawrence get situated. Maybe you should stay out of the sun for a while, Candace.
Thanks for coming, everyone! I think we can call this one a draw.
Or, as the ancient Romans call it, Madam Stabilis.
Oh, man!
Another blown budget.
I know!
Pardon me. Are you boys, Phineas Flynn and Ferb Fletcher?
We sure are.
Bob Community, founder of the Danville Community Center. We're putting on a little shindig tonight, and I couldn't help but notice by the giant Flavian amphitheater flying out of your backyard that you boys have exceptional lighting design. I know it's short notice, but I'd like to put on a little show for the Danville Community Dance.
Third?
I know what we're going to do tonight.
Sure, Mr. Community. We'd love to help.
Well, splendid. But please, call me Bob.
Candace, where have you been? Red Team was down a player when you ran off. We probably could have won. Instead, it ended in a stupid tie.
Doesn't it all seem too convenient?
Yeah, I'm not a huge fan of the everyone's a winner mentality. It's conditioning our youth to become unaccustomed to failure.
I don't care what you say! I beat you!
No, I mean, doesn't it all seem too convenient that the entire Colosseum disappeared just like that, seconds before Mom was home to see it?
Huh. I guess you're right. It kind of just floated away. That's pretty out of the ordinary.
The only thing that's out of the ordinary is that this isn't out of the ordinary. This happens every day, whether it's a hover car, a roller coaster, a full-scale model of the Eiffel Tower. It always, always goes away. And Phineas and Ferb get away with the whole thing. Because Mom is never in the room where it happens.
Every day? Doesn't that sound kind of formulaic?
Oh, there you are, Perry.
Anyone want some pie?
It's extremely formulaic. I've been doomed to a Sisyphean fate for the entire summer. At this point, I can pretty much predict exactly what will happen when I try again. Ooh, ooh, Mom!
Candace, be calm.
Did you see the thing the boys built that gave me a huge qualm?
No.
You know the old tire swing?
Yeah.
They made it a hover car. Now it's got a working intercom.
Sure.
All you have to do is look.
Now those are words I've heard.
They're in the yard by the brook.
Hi, Mom.
Now how are they flying on that small old tire?
No, it was just there, Mom. I swear I'm not a liar.
Stress less. Smile more.
Uh-huh.
Do whatever it takes to end this eternal fraternal war.
But Phineas and Ferb are relentless.
Having fun doesn't make them sinners.
No, but they...
Sorry, Candace, I've gotta go.
But Mom!
I've gotta get started on dinner.
A triangle and a rectangle sit in the backyard. Brothers way younger than men. 10. They emerge with some blueprints for inventions that haven't been thought of since the pen. Then, the adolescents build one with unprecedented constructive efficiency, an escalator that can take you to the moon. Or a roller coaster spanning the town built in a morning. But then it's gone that afternoon. No one's ever in the room where it happens, the room where it happens, the room where it happens. No one's ever in the room where it happens, the room where it happens, the room where it happens. No one really knows how the gadgets here, which are quite severe, all just disappear. And Mom assumes it never happened, because she's never in the room where it happens. Brothers claim.
People new things every day. I don't know where they go, but they get out of our way.
Balji claims.
It is peculiar they go missing. Have you tried forming a hypothesis using retrodiction?
Buford claims.
Where did hovercraft go? Well, I'd tell you if you bribed me, but I really don't know.
Girl Scouts claim.
I don't know why you've been pleading. I just made the engine.
The paint job.
The seating.
So no one's ever in the room where it happens. The room where it happens. The room where it happens. The reason why they're never still around tomorrow. And Mom assumes it never happened, because she's never in the room where it happens. Meanwhile,
Nessa is grappling with the fact that her father spends his waking hours trying to be evil.
Meanwhile,
Alka is celebrating back at their capital.
It's an upheaval.
Then Jeremy texts Candace about their impending date night, and Candace responds with her 15-year-old insight.
Maybe we could solve one problem with the other, and you can help me bust my little brothers, in other words.
Oh no, a bro side show?
Can you go?
Can't we just enjoy the dance and go with the flow?
Well, I'd love to, but...
This is a chance you can't blow?
Me so well, you know. We'll be a snippy duo.
Let's go.
Oh!
We're gonna find the room where it happens. The room where it happens. The room where it happens. We're on our way to find the room where it happens. The room where it happens. The room where it happens.
My God, this girl is nuts. And she's never gonna stop until she gets the bust. But her fervor's got me rapping. I guess I'll help her find the room where it happens.
Danville City Maintenance.
What happened to my brother's plane that conveniently float on down the river?
Patch a delivery co.
Where'd my brothers get the funds to finance the express excessive girders you deliver?
Ferb and Phineas Flynn.
Did you know it doesn't even matter how big and noticeable your inventions are?
It's not about the scale, it's about having fun.
You built a haunted mansion.
And fun is what we won. When we have an idea, we see it through to the end. And if we build what we envision, we don't have to pretend. We've got one summer and we won't ignore it. School's coming, we won't
wait for it, wait for it.
Wait! No, it's too much mayhem. There's gotta be some reason that nothing outlives them. It's gotta be somewhere. It's gotta be someone. It can't just be magic. So who is this someone?
I want to be in the room where it happens. The room where it happens. I want to be in the room where it happens. The room where it happens. I want to be in the room.
The room where it happens.
In trouble and I'll re-earn Mom's trust.
How about a leader who can really serve?
When I'm in charge, my bro will get what he deserves.
Is now the time to intervene.
I'm gonna overcome this age-old routine. Old as the tomb I was trapped in.
I've got to be in the room where it happens.
I've got to be
the room where it happens.
I've got to be
the room where it happens.
Boom.
Oh, this is my self-destruct button.